Hi everyone, my name is Jeremy and welcome to Creepy Tale. Today I'm going to be playing this game alongside my wife, Ashley. Say hi.
Hello everyone and welcome to Creepy Tale.
Okay. Ooh. Okay, that's weird. So, this is a game that I've seen it on Steam, I've seen it on the Nintendo Switch, and it caught my eye because when I saw the previews, I really liked the art style, and it's a really cheap game, it's like $5, something like that, and I bought it because I said I'm pretty sure my wife is going to enjoy this game, so I could probably play it with her, because she's a fan of the Brothers Grimm, of fairy tales and stuff like that.
I am a Grimm fanatic!
Yeah, but not the beautiful fairy tales that Disney tells us. No,
she likes OG.
Yeah, she likes the OG stuff, the dark stuff, you know?
You know what I'm talking about.
So I thought, you know, this game's going to be right up her alley. And honestly, I like the art style, so I know I'm going to enjoy it. So let's get into it. Apparently, this game is just a horror game with the ambiance and the aesthetics of a Brothers Grimm fairy tale. And we're going to find that out. Let's go.
Chapter 1. Beautiful Butterfly.
Apparently, I think they don't talk. They speak with animations or symbols.
Yes. So this is a pretty standard control. You move left and right, use the arrow keys for that, you jump with spacebar, and you pick up stuff or interact with Z. I also found out that you can jump with the up button, I mean the up arrow key, so...
Okay. Simple enough. Okay, that's weird.
You know how these kids be.
Ooh. Yeah, it's just weird that the soundtrack appears, like the bubbly, goofy music appears for like a moment and it just cuts off.
Brother?
What exactly are those guys?
I think they're like trolls or something.
They look horrible.
We're in the house, guys.
Oh, and the noise that they make, oh my god, I almost felt it in my throat, oh god.
It's very guttural.
Yeah. Oh, and that's pretty cool, the butterfly is like their soul or something.
Or this is more like a skin.
Yeah, like a body. What's that supposed to be?
I have no idea.
But it looks like their arm. It looks like their arm. So apparently, like, the game seems to be pretty simple, honestly.
Yeah, so far so good, at least. We made it out. I just like how he goes, when there's something to interact. <know. laughs> let's go to that bitch. What are you in
yeah,
the background?
Yeah, what the heck is that? That's horrible. It's just there in the background, like, watching
button?
You.
A button? Brother!
Oh, but there's a trap on the floor.
Should I fall for this obvious trap set by whatever is in the background?
Hmm. Maybe.
Science!
Oh, there was like a weird thing down there.
Science again!
No, there's no way for you to survive that.
Okay. Was my body still down there? Science no. again!
No, it's just leaves.
All right.
Okay, so now you can jump. What the heck is that?
Shh, sleeping.
He looks like a naked mole rat. Wait until you see him. He reminds me of Rufus from Kim Possible, but like a really dark, evil version of him. Ooh.
Oh my god,
yeah.
No. Let's see if I can. Oh, come on. I thought I could climb it. Wait, I have to.
That's
be able
so
to
uncomfortable
climb it.
To watch.
First try. What do you mean?
It's like maybe you need to pour something onto them so they get lifted up. Because it's almost like a dead tree, almost.
I don't understand what it's saying.
Was there water on the other side?
I actually don't know.
Oh, he can jump! Oh my god, it's so disgusting. Okay, so there's nothing there?
Mm.
Oh. So maybe you need to like break the mushroom so that it liberates the toxins near the tree.
Let's do that.
Well, I know he can jump, but I didn't know he could go up the tree. Oh, he fell. Oh my god. Okay. I'm pretty sure he's alive, so.
For science! If you stay too long, you fall.
Oh, that's the reason why you needed to do that.
Incorrigible researcher. Of course. I see. Sneaky game, sneaky.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting,
yeah,
honestly.
I like
simple
it.
But interesting puzzles, you know?
Yeah. Thank you. things alive. Let's see. I have to bait it.
Oh my god. What is this? At least he doesn't do anything to you. He just kills you. But they don't show it, I mean. Why are all the monsters so disgusting and creepy? With such a beautiful art style. He looks so horrible.
It makes it all the more the better.
Too slow.
Man, that thing is fast.
Oh, he is floating. How do you plan on using that? Because there's nothing to hold it up.
Everything is done for science.
Yeah. Man, you have to get so close. Gonna scream. Wow, is he not going to scream? Oh god. Oh no, he's so fast. He slows down after a certain point, but you know.
I think I get it. Maybe.
Okay, what do you think you need to do? You think he's gonna fall? He's floating.
My work.
It seems to be the only solution, but that's kind of weird.
Cause he floats. Overshot it by just a teeny.
He just stops and looks at you like, what are you doing? Oh god, no. But you must be onto something, because he slows down after you get off the bridge.
Yeah. What are you gonna do?
Oh, you're smart!
Stupid butterfly. Squishy. Oh, don't worry.
He wants a piece of you.
Chapter 2. Obscure side of the forest. Hello? Hello? Hello?
And you say hi to a creature looking at you through the window.
May I come in? Mr. Tomnus, is that you?
What's the reference? I don't know. Is that Narnia?
Yeah.
Oh.
Can I borrow this? Well, don't be afraid. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Yeah, why is he shy? He's horrible. So is this creature like usually? Have you ever heard of this creature?
Oh, he looks like a satyr.
What's that supposed to be?
Well, Mr. Tomnus is.
Are they supposed to be friendly?
I don't know. I'm taking your paws. Dang it.
Oh, you could grab the stick. Wow, how are you supposed to even know that without the hints? Okay, so maybe now you can jump to the other side and maybe you can grab the skull. Because maybe you're supposed to put a skull on the dead body, on the food or carcass that you have. No?
No.
Oh, you know that you have to put out the fire.
Yeah.
Okay, so you didn't need to cook it or anything. Okay. now we have like an old lady. What's the inspiration? Because I feel that we're getting really.
She's supposed to be a witch.
And we're getting like really Nordic, with the runes and the door. If you look at the door, that looks like an Yggdrasil type of symbol.
It leads to Narnia in reality.
All right, because that's not a door. That's a closet.
This reminds me a little bit of Tiny Thief. It had like a perspective similar to that.
Wow, I forgot about Tiny Thief. It's been a while.
Yeah, they canceled that game after a while, unfortunately. It was a really good game. I really liked it.
It was a cell phone game, right?
Yeah, it was a mobile game. I hear purring. Oh, there you are, kitty. You didn't see anything. So what type of mushroom is she using?
Oh, look at the picture. It's like blue, jello, and red.
Thank you.
And so one on the right, that's the blue one. The orange one, yeah, that one.
Oh. So it substitutes one for another. I have to do it one at a time, I guess.
And I think it's the little red one. Oh, there are two of them. No, I think it's that one. Yeah, you chose the right one.
Poison. I need a vial.
She looks creepy.
I like her look.
She makes me think of Baba Yaga, but I don't think they're referencing that. I'm not sure. No, and I think she's just an old, like a witch or something like that. Something more generic, maybe. Do you see whatever it is that you need?
I'm waiting for her to move to the far side of the room.
And is there something to the right? No, there's the door. Okay. So you need to hide in the closet.
Yeah.
Whatever it is that you need, it's either near the closet or in the first room. I think. I'm not sure. God, those sounds are so disgusting. Okay, I wonder, can you take the mushroom? Well, are the mushrooms the same mushrooms available?
No.
Oh, you can't do them and draw without anymore, okay.
There it is.
Got a bottle, reminds you, an empty bottle. Reminds you of Zelda now.
You see the butterfly though?
Yeah, yeah. So maybe those guys are her creation?
I don't know. I could have left it open. I wonder if she would have noticed if something was awry.
There we go, a little bit of salt and pepper. With a little hint of death.
Oh yes, just how I like it.
Ooh, she's dead.
I'll take that.
No, you can open the door.
No, I know. I just wanted to see if there were any more secrets or something.
Okay guys, so we're gonna stop here. I think this game is like really, really, really short. I think it's a really short game. So maybe we're gonna be able to finish it like in 2 episodes or something like that. I'm not sure. But up until this point, it's just a simple, cute, horror puzzle game. And I'm really liking it. It's just simple. It's good. I don't know what you think.
I'm digging it.
Yeah, she likes it. If it looks like a fairy tale, it looks like the Brothers Grimm's fairy tales, you know, she's gonna love it. So yeah, that's about it. We're gonna keep trying to find our doofus brothers. Because honestly, He's a doofus. Why did he go off following the butterfly?
Because that's what kids in fairy tales do. There's no plot if there's no MacGuffin.
No, they just need... They need a fairy godmother and they need to ask for a brain. Because they don't have common sense. So I hope you guys are enjoying this and we'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Goodbye.
Hi everyone, if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel to keep up to date with our content.